Hey guys, Gary J here. Today we're looking at our Technic stereo system, which people have different names for it, Technic or Technic. Japanese say it just a little bit differently, but these are really nice systems. They came out in the 1990s, 2000, I guess, and they're big, heavy units, and they're well made, and for most people, it'll last them a lifetime, I think. And you can get these big, tall speakers here. That speaker weighs like 45 pounds, and I got two of those, and it's really heavy, and huge speakers in it, and a tweeter and all. And then you have like a small speaker here. You can go from the small speakers, which are, sound really good, to go to main speakers, which would be these monsters here. But at the top we have a record player, and below that we have a tuner, and then we have a cassette player, and then we have a 5 CD changer, which is super nice. And a lot of these units come with remote controls too, which made it really nice. But let's take a look at Technic here. The tuner's pretty neat. You have your AM, FM, and all of that. And your volume over here, and your little button here for your right and left balance. And your equalizer right here. You can go up and down with that and alter that. Right over here, you got a button here. You got a couple of them. One you push down for like regular speakers. One, I think, up for your main speaker, which are these tower speakers. And it's already set on a FM program. It goes right here. It says tuner, CD, which does the cassette player and the CD, and phonograph or record player. And then you can hook your VCR, two different VCRs up to it, so your music would play through this system here, which was pretty cool back in the 90s. And 2000s, I guess. So we hit tuner right here.
Signs connected to Jefferson Highway, while the third would relocate monuments on broad streets. Moving.
The Bull, the At Work Show with me for the Greenwood as we.
But here's the phonograph on the record player, and power button's here, and the speed is here, which is 33. 45 is for the small record. Repeat if you want to hear this over and over again. And cueing allows you to press cueing, and your sound arm here, tuning arm here, comes up, and then you just slide it to the a particular track that you want to hear and press cueing, and it drops it down perfectly. There's no way to pick up this thing hardly without scratching the record or making some strange noises. But if when you turn it on, it just like start button here and stop button, it goes to where it's supposed to, and it'll track all the way across. Tuning arms here have a really unique system in the back of them. They have adjustments, so you can control the speed of this arm as it goes across the record, in the sense that it's not going too fast or being pushed unduly. And also allows you to balance this arm right here so that it's not pressing down too hard on the record itself. So those are a couple of adjustments. Now we'll hit play. You watch this arm, it'll come up, and it'll go to where it's supposed to go. And I'm talking to some of these people who are millennials who've never seen some of this technology. You guys know what I'm talking to on some of this. So and something millennials don't know, too, is that this is Glenn Campbell. For some of us, his voice was always iconic, like Elvis Presley and others like that. Beautiful singer. His voice was just amazing.
I guess I should say anything at all.
Now, there's a debate that's been going on a long time. Does a record player play better than a CD player? A lot of people believe it does. And why is that? Because CDs are compressed music. MP3 files are compressed music too. So if they're compressed, you don't get all the sound that you really want out of it. That's the debate. Whereas these are not compressed, so you can hear the sound better in one sense. So that's kind of the debate, that phonographs can play better, have better sound quality, more rich quality than compressed files or CDs. So you can study up on that. These stereo systems just have a different ambience to them. So that's the attraction to them. They don't sound like a MP3 file or CD or something like that. And you watch your, well, here's the cueing right here. Watch the needle come up. See, it just hovers right there, and you just slide it over and drop it wherever you want to. And then you would hit cueing again and watch the needle drop. So it drops precisionally. And then off. And then it drops down. And your record player stops. So, which is better, record or CD or MP3 files? Now, some of these record players cost over $4,000. You can get them from $50 on up, but some will go over $4,000. So we go to a cassette player, and CD right here would be the one that we want to hit. And you see CD come up right here. So this is a CD cassette player. And you've got a cassette on this side. You can record. You can play both. You can record music off other components on the here too. And so that's pretty neat. You see there is a lot of buttons here to do a lot of different things. And all kind of adjustments and recording and sound and all that right here when you're recording something to a cassette. And I have to control the volume. Now, when you hit play on this, it's a lot louder. It's a lot louder than the phonograph. I mean, you can turn the phonograph up, but it's louder than the other components. Now that's Celine Dion, which is a great singer. Now, this is a 5-CD changer right here. And these are really nice right here. You better put 5 CDs in here. And this one is really a nice design here on the Technic, because you can, with 5 CDs, you can choose a song like from each one of the CDs you want to listen to. And this thing will pick them out for you and rotate the carousel that the CDs are on. That's it. This is the way they are. You can rotate this carousel right here, and you can see all the different ones. And this is like Enya, Johnny Cash, I think Rolling Stones, and Bon Jovi, and I can't think of the other one. But It'll rotate this carousel and pick out songs from each one of these if you want to program it to do that, which is pretty neat. And So you can push your track number here, whatever track you want to hear it here. Now, like the CD is set at number 3. If you want to listen to number 3, if you want to listen to number 1, press number 1. Number 1 comes up right here. That would be Enya. Enya brought Celtic music to the world in the 80s. It had been around a long time, but as far as worldwide, she's probably the number one person that brought it to the whole world. Beautiful music, Celtic music. We hit all. We hit number 2. And you see the carousel spin. And we're on track 1. This is your buddy here, Bon Jovi. Cut it off. Go to 3. You see 3 pops up. I think that's Rolling Stones there. That's Celtic women there. It's Enya is Celtic, but this is Celtic women. Celtic women are a beautiful group. I've seen them live before. They travel all over the world. But that's a beautiful song there. You got 5 women generally singing Celtic women, I think. And you have just Enya when she sings her stuff. And 5.
Everybody knows where you go when the sun goes down. I think you only live to see the lights of town. I wasted my time.
Well, you see how that works. Okay, guys, just wanted to show you the Technic system, and these are really nice systems. You can find them sometimes on eBay. If you can find a guy, there are some stores that, very few, that actually rebuild these things and get pretty good quality, but they cost you about $250 to $300 a piece if you have one that's been rebuilt. So it's, I mean, that's for each component, the ones that have been rebuilt, refurbished and all. But these will last you a lifetime if you take care of them. So what kind of people listen to stereo systems like this, the old style? I think generally people that are country people. Right here I got like antique fly rods, black powder rifles, boomerangs, archery stuff. So we're pretty much country. The old radio on the right there. back from the 40s in a Philco. So, some of us like the old stuff. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Gary J.